When an engine manufacturer is building a jet engine, they're designing specific tooling to either assemble or disassemble. The tooling gets purchased in kind of waves, and it only gets purchased when it's needed for that wave. So there's not a lot of quantity that's ever needed. You know, if we make a lot of one tool, 5 or 6 builds in a whole year, that's a lot.
In this facility, we pretty much run the gamut of materials. Because the support equipment that we do, they're full assemblies, and one assembly may have 4 different types of material, might have 7 different types of material, and you're making every single one of those pieces. So anything from plastic to Inconel, we run it all.
We had 8 Hurco milling machines, and one of the things that me and the rest of the team kept talking about was how we were underpowered in the lathe department. We're underpowered.
Just begging my boss. I need a more accurate lathe. I need a lathe that can really remove the material.
Last year was a great year for us, so when we were looking at reinvesting in the company, we made the decision to invest in a TM12 and the VMX42. And then, you know, a couple other things happened, and we were like, well, how fast can we get another lathe in here? Brooks was really great. You know, it was supply chain issues at the time, and they had the TMX8 on a boat scheduled to come over in the next couple weeks, and we were like, yeah, let's take it. So the thought process over here was that we were gonna try a new working cell. So historically, we had always had lathes, mills, and then we would exit manufacturing, but we wanted to give our toolmakers the opportunity to have a lathe and a mill together. So we started bringing these together to try that option out. We had only ever had prototype toolroom lathes before that.
The lathe is repeating right on the money. Repeatability is important. You don't want variances from part to part, and you don't get any of that. It's just the rigidity, I think, is excellent. What you set it to, that's the next part you're gonna have, it's gonna be that way.
We actually don't have boring heads because we can circularly interpolate to the tolerance that we deal with. I can't remember the last time we put a boring head in one of the machines. Not that the machine couldn't do it, but the machine can actually do it without it. That, to me, is a perfect explanation of how accurate these machines are. Relying on the machinery is something we do on a regular basis, and it hasn't let us down.
I was a little leery at first with the conversational. I've done a lot of hand G-code programming, some MasterCam as well. I hadn't really found a conversational one I trusted, but the Hurco, I gotta say, I really like it because you can do just about anything you need to do. Just about all the tools that we make, we can program it right on the machine.
It's more about throughput for us. We don't have the resources to have like a programming team in the front. We can't have a program for a new product go out onto the floor, have issues, go back to the front, get fixed, come back to the floor, have an issue. I need everything to happen right at the machine quickly so that they can make that one part and then move on to the next part, and then move on to the next part.
Having that graphic screen where you just hit a button and it draws what you have in there, that's by far the easiest graphics verification I've seen on a control. You just hit draw. And I think that's one of its most powerful features, because if you're paying close attention to that, even little minor imperfections, they'll show up.
Our experience with Hurco has been very, very positive. I remember one time there was an update that happened and it caused something else to not work within the system. And then working directly with Hurco to figure it out, come up with a new update that corrected it. So they've always been very proactive and very responsive to the requests. I know the service department that we use has been phenomenal. Really have had very little need for other than PMs. They want your input. We've been able to see the result of our input. So very, very positive.